simple to describe, and I'm happy to take this on the floor now.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It is a very simple amendment of my amendment, which will amend the previous amendment, which will be to simply add at the end of the amendment that the ruling group has proposed what my amendment is, because I think it goes further in what the council should be looking at in terms of a review of HMOs in the city. It starts by stating that there is a lack of affordable housing in this city, and that affordable housing actually is not that affordable for most people in the city. It starts by pointing out that there are problems in the fact we have very few council houses being built in this city, which would be truly affordable, Mr. Mayor. It then goes on to say that we need to have a look from the tenants' perspective at what they think of shared housing. So, for example, Mr. Mayor, we would look at things about agents' fees, rents, the quality and so on of the housing. It would do a comprehensive a review as the Labour Party's proposal would, but wouldn't be prescribing, whether directly or implicitly, caps on numbers, but would be taken into account in a general review, even though this is not explicitly stated. Review will cover everything, Mr. Mayor. And then this obviously needs to tie in with the local plan review, which is ongoing, something that the amendment proposed by Councillor Smart, of your party, Mr. Mayor, didn't state. There was nothing about that in the amendment that the council has just accepted, which is, in my view, lacking. Mr. Mayor, I'm grateful to the Labour Party for bringing this motion forward. Sorry, for bringing their motion forward. It's good to put this onto the table. But the way they've done it, Mr. Mayor, in the text form, is rather scary. I'm grateful to Councillor March and Daisy for elaborating more on what this motion actually means tonight, but although she has elaborated on that, it hasn't changed the wording of this motion. And so I hope, Mr. Mayor, that both the Labour Party and your colleagues in the Liberal Democrats will agree that perhaps my amendment adds more to the motion and has a more thorough review without scaring HMO owners and so on as it is. Mr. Mayor, Councillor Martinetti, I don't know whether this comment was directed at me too, as well as the ruling group, but it's not true that I don't want to look at anything to improve the situation. I'm taking objection solely to the bit in their motion about the 25% cap and the review of that. And I would say this, if it is not the intention of the Labour Party to propose a 25% cap on and have 200 metre stretches of streets and so on, then why is this in the wording of their motion? Why not make the motion a generally worded statement? If you look at the Labour Party's manifesto, it says that they're going to look to use planning powers to limit the percentage of houses in any particular area that can be HMOs. Now, even though it was a state percentage, why is there now a percentage in this? Why not have worded it in a more general and more review-oriented sense? And that's the problem I have with this motion as it stands. It comes across as being prescriptive in this matter. And Councillor Marchand Days at the end of her summing up stated that it wasn't a limit on the total numbers that the Labour Party wishes to adopt, but that it was to be spread across the whole city, HMOs. But I'm not sure whether Grange Road or some of the leafy streets in Newnham would be a possible place to have HMOs given the price of houses there. And if they were, and the buyer of the house purchased the house for the high price that is attracted in that area, what would the rents be in that area? They would be a lot higher. And I think having a cap of 25% in X area will reduce the supply of housing that falls as shared housing. And if there's a reduction in apply, and Councillor Herbert did point out that demand is inelastic for housing in the city, which I absolutely agree is the case, then the prices will rise extortionately. Not only that, the increased costs, as Councillor Waters said, will increase bureaucracy, which will increase costs to the people seeking to rent rooms in houses, because given the inelastic demand for housing, what else will the price do but be passed on to the people looking to rent? So, Mr. Mayor, that's why I proposed my amendment. Hopefully it's not seen as against X or against Y. It's hoping to make the review much stronger, have a broader base. It might require a bit more work, but I think the tenants renting, people renting in HMOs in the city deserve a thorough review of what the problems are and so on, and looking at how the council could improve its service in monitoring this without being prescriptive and proposing caps. But, Mr. Mayor, we've got to bear in mind that more needs to be done in building more affordable housing, more council housing in particular in the city, and that is the thrust of the amendment that I've put forward.
Is there a councillor to second that? Councillor Ward,
seconding? Yes, I'll second it. I'll speak later if necessary.